I intended on making this video a long time ago, but some more trailers came out and I wanted to incorporate them. And every year I always make a big deal about the summer movie season. I think all movie buffs really like it. It's just fun, really just awesome, you know, from the months May through August. It's just awesome, and it's one of the things that got me into movies a couple summers back, so I owe a lot to it. Before I go into my most anticipated movies, I'm going to run through the big movies coming out this summer. Starting on May 6th, we have the Marvel summer movie opener, Thor. It's getting great reviews from what I hear. It's a fun movie, and it does. It looks like an enjoyable way to kick off the season. There's Priest, which could go either or way. I'm not really expecting much from it. I mean, the second weekend in May tends to be dull, so this one's really no exception anyway. And then we have May 20th, one of the biggest movies of the summer, Pirates of the Caribbean on Stranger Tides. I'm really looking forward to this movie. It looks like it's trying to gear itself more towards the fun, yet still action-packed Curse of the Black Pearl, rather than at World's End, which just tried to do so much and really could. It didn't have the support frame. While I do have my concerns, I am really looking forward to this movie, and, you know, if all else fails, it's still got Keith. Then there's a very contended weekend between Kung Fu Panda 2 and The Hangover 2. I, personally, looking forward to Kung Fu Panda 2 much more. You probably call me, like, little baby or something. I don't know, whatever immature humor you guys want to use. But seriously, I really am in no way, not a fraction of the way, looking forward to The Hangover 2. I mean, not just because I liked the original one. It's okay. It's not one of the best comedies ever, like, claimed so. But this one looks horrible. It looks like a complete repetition of the first movie, complete rehash. And the one thing that made the first movie good was that it's a clever way of telling the story, and this one, by doing the same thing, just ruins the scheme. I wasn't really particularly impressed with the footage I've seen from Kung Fu Panda 2, but I really like the first one as a breath of fresh air for DreamWorks, and I'm still very much looking forward to number 2. I swear, if anybody makes poop jokes. In the first week of June, we get X-Men First Class, which has been severely under-marketed. I mean, X-Men is a big, big title, but I guess it's because the namesake cast is gone. You know, big ones like Hugh Jackman, Halle Berry. But at the same time, I really wasn't thinking much. And then the trailers came out, and the most recent one, I think it looks fairly good. Then we have Super 8, which looks like popcorn flick fun. It's almost as though J.J. Abrams is creating a movie that's like a love letter to Steven Spielberg's older Alien movies. Seems to be a good old-fashioned fun time, and I am intensely looking forward to this movie. Then there's the Green Lantern, which I think everybody agrees the first trailer sucked, and then the WonderCon footage came out and kind of blew us all away. Not that it was all that great, but in comparison, holy shit. I'm still very skeptical about the movie, but now it looks like it could at least be somewhat good. Then we have Cars 2. I mean, this is how you follow up Toy Story 3, Pixar. This is how you follow up 4 years of awesomeness. Alright, you had Cars, and then you came out with Ratatouille, won everybody back, awesome, right? WALL-E amazed everybody, Up! Made everybody cry, and then Toy Story 3 made everybody cry all over again. I mean, just 4 years of amazement. Truly, I think I've given every one of those movies 10 out of 10. They were on a streak, and then they come out with Cars 2. I mean, it's Pixar. I'll go and see it. I'll still look forward to it somewhat. But the recent trailer, I mean, just why are you? It looks like a DreamWorks movie. It does. Like, did Disney just come on and just strap a giant dildo and fuck you into making this movie? I just got carried away. No, but I really am. I'm sick of Pixar's originality being... I'm sick of Pixar's originality being taken away from them just because Disney wants to make money off of a title that they already know is successful and can sell as a brand, and it's annoying. Disney, tits or GTFO, and by tits I mean originality. So, GTFO. So, after those ironic explosions of vulgarity during the previewing of a family movie, let's move on. We have Transformers Dark of the... I'm not going to finish the title because it's ridiculously offensive to Pink Floyd fans and people who have a general, fundamental understanding of the English language and the grammar that ensues upon it. With the Transformers series, I've never been a Michael Bay fan, but I can at least say that the first movie while being mindless, it still sufficed to be enjoyable. It's just a blockbuster movie. But the second one just has complete disregard for just everything, and it's a terrible, horrible movie. So I can't, even though the trailer, I didn't like it all. It was obnoxious, just loud, bang, bang. The score, completely overdone, just ridiculously derivative, and just horrible. I cannot shake the memory of Transformers 2 to give me any sliver of hope for that movie. I mean, maybe, just maybe, they'll go back to Transformers, the original one, where they tried somewhat, but I cannot forgive Michael Bay ever for Transformers 2. Then we have Zookeeper, which is essentially Paul Blart in a zoo with talking animals. Why? And the holy of holies, Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part Dos. I could honestly shit my pants from excitement right now. Right now. But I won't. Honestly, that teaser trailer was just the definition of epic. And I lament using that term nowadays, because it's just been overused. But wow, I cannot wait for July. If the rest of the summer sucks, we still have Harry Potter. Because I know it is impossible for that movie to suck. I don't want to be the one guy who sits in the theater right before the movie starts and I'm like, what if it sucks? I'm going to be dedicating, like, literally, like, a month on this channel just to Harry Potter before that movie comes out. Just making videos on books and the movies and all that other fun stuff. So I'm not going to get too into it right now, but holy crap of anticipation. Then there's Captain America, and I always really like period pieces, so a superhero period piece sounds really cool. Chris Evans looks like he's rocking being a superhero again. Maybe this movie will be good. I mean, I really like the trailer, so looks fun. Then there's Cowboys and Aliens, and now this movie succeeds. Then there's Cowboys and Aliens, and this movie looks like it'll succeed because it looks like it's not going to take itself too seriously. Because, you know, it's working with this potentially goofy premise with two cliched genres and kind of satiring them, but at the same time looking extremely intense, extremely gritty, but looking like it's a self-aware movie, that it's kind of dumb, but still looks really fucking awesome. Just having Olivia Wilde in a movie doesn't sell you. This movie has James Bond and Indiana Jones. In the same weekend, there's the Smurfs, which is essentially Alvin and the Chipmunks, with blue things. Why? Again. On to August, there's Rise of the Planet of the Apes, which up until recently, I didn't really know what to think. There's really never been any prequel material from all of the subsequent Planet of the Apes movies. And so, for that reason, I was like, okay, maybe this movie could be cool. And the trailer seems to look pretty decent. I mean, James Franco, awesome. I'm looking forward to this movie. The rest of August is kind of a blur of big titles where you wonder why they're being made, like Final Destination 5, Conan the Barbarian remake, Fright Night remake, Spy Kids 4, two unnecessary sequels, two unnecessary remakes. I mean, I guess because they're big titles, there's some little sliver of looking forward to in there, but just, I don't see why any of them needed to be produced. That's the majority of the big names of the summer. It looks like it could be another 2007 in anticipation, because we don't want another 2007 summer disappointment on our hands. Spider-Man 3, At World's End, Shrek the Third, I mean, come on, Silver Surfer. I didn't really get a chance to go into the Tree of Life, but that is, I always forget to talk about this movie because I always just kind of I try to focus specifically on the blockbusters, which is why I didn't talk about the Tree of Life, which I'm really looking forward to, because the summer is a time for, you know, blockbusters, but, you know, every once in a while, like 2009, Hurt Locker, 500 Days of Summer, Moon, we got a lot of unexpected non-blockbuster awesomeness, so yeah, Tree of Life looks good. Fast Five already gave the box office a boost. Hopefully the summer continues it. I don't know, I'm really excited for this summer. It looks like it could be awesome. 2010, while it had some very few really awesome movies, overall just faltered. So yes, so excited! Ah, this is only a couple days away now, you know, checking my watch there and all. Now, without further ado, I'm gonna roll my list of summer movies I'm looking forward to, or the most, top 10. Some just kind of got cut off, but I was trying to think of, like, a summer song to put in there, like, you know, summer-themed song, and I went through, like, some app, like, CR, and it's a Joplin, Beach Boys, but I landed on one. I hope you guys like it.
Summertime.